गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, आई डॉक्टर अलंकृत एलन जे आर थ्री रेडियो डायग्नोसिस एट आई पी जी में आर विल बी प्रेजेंटिंग माई पेपर ऑन द टॉपिक पैटर्न ऑफ इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ लोअर लिम आर्टरीज इन एथरोस्क्लेरोटिक डिजीज कोरिलेशन बाय डॉपलर एंड सीटी एंजियोग्राफी। पेरिफेरल आर्टेरियल ऑब्ट्रूसिव डिजीज कॉमनली रेफर टू एज पेरिफेरल आर्टेरियल डिजीज और पेरिफेरल वैस्कुलर डिजीज रेफर्स टू द obstruction or deterioration of arteries other than those supplying the heart and within the brain. There are few studies in literature which have analyzed the vascular insufficiency distribution patterns and simultaneously correlated it clinically. The aims and objectives of this study were to diagnose and assess anatomical site and distribution of lower limb atherosclerosis, assessment of the severity of the vascular change by simultaneous use of UHD Doppler and CT angiography. And thirdly, to help in treatment of atherosclerotic peripheral vascular disease in lower limb arteries. The material and methods. The present study comprised of 30 patients. Patients with lower limb claudication, wrist pain, gangrene, referred to the Department of Radio Diagnosis from Department of CTVS and other departments were screened by UHD Doppler first. If UHG screening revealed atherosclerotic changes in lower limb arteries, he/she was further evaluated by CT angiography. Result: in our study 8, that is 26.7% of the patients were 30 to 40 years old. 20%, that is 66. 20 of them, that is 66.7% patients were 41 to 50 years old, and 2, that is 6.7% patients were 51 to 60 years old. 11 patients were female and 19 were male. 21 patients had history of DM. 15 patients had history of hypertension and 14 patients had history of smoking. This is the result, that is a distribution of age in years and according to the various parameters that have been described here. Distribution of age in years, distribution of history of hypertension, gangrene, according to history of smoking, and right-sided arterial wall thickening plaque, color change, and DM. The various results have been displayed accordingly, which you can see on your screen. In our study, 25 patients had color change, and 16 patients had gangrene. At right limbs, patient had common femoral arterial wall thickening. So at right-sided arterial system, predominant distribution of wall thickening and plaque is at superficial femoral artery, popliteal artery, and anterior tibial artery. In left limbs, 16 of them had common femoral arterial wall thickening. So overall distribution of wall thickening and plaque at PA, ATA, PT at left side of arterial system. And accordingly, this bar diagram below represents that. The distribution of diffuse or focal involvement of right-sided arterial system. As you can see in the table, it has been listed here, the findings. Distribution of diffuse or focal involvement of left-sided arterial system and right-sided accordingly. Now, in the conclusion, majority of patients were male, that is 19 out of 30. And there was a significant correlation between lower limb atherosclerotic disease and history of diabetes. Superficial femoral artery, popliteal artery, anterior tibial artery, posterior tibial artery predominantly showed atherosclerotic wall thickening and plaque disease. Calcification effects almost equally all the lower limb arteries are affected. Diffuse pattern of arterial involvement is predominant pattern in atherosclerotic disease rather than focal luminal compromise. These are the references which I had used. Thank you.